My name is Kevin Burrows, and this is my story of what it was like growing up without a father. My intentions in sharing just a little tad bit of my story is not to degrade the man that is my father, but rather just share some insight and hopefully help those that might be battling with growing up without their father today. Being abandoned by someone that is supposed to love you is very painful. I never could come to grips with why. My father didn't want anything to do with me, didn't want to be involved in my life. Many nights I cried, many nights I wondered, you know, if and when I would ever see him. It left me kind of empty inside, and oftentimes clinged to any male figure that showed interest in me. I was lonely at times without having that male figure in my life. I grew up on the east side of town. I'm actually going to be turning down the street where I actually grew up on. And it wasn't the worst neighborhood, but I did find myself getting involved with selling drugs. Right here is actually where my house used to be. I believe it burned down. But right here is a double. And we lived here for several years, and bring back so many memories. Now this is the corner right where that store is where I stood and sold drugs. And God has been good. I'm grateful, because it was one night that I ended up getting arrested. All right, so we're standing on 21st Street right now. This is actually back in the day known as 21 Jump. This is where it all went down at. Sold drugs on this street, shot craps on this street, hung out with my friends on this street, and it's also the street that I got arrested on. I was actually scared straight that night. Decisions I made, you know, that were not the best decision was due to the fact that I didn't have a father figure in my life to help guide me and help me make the right decisions that I need to make in life. So I'm grateful for who I am today and the man God has made me to be. When I was 18 years old, I gave my life to God. It was then that God transformed my life, transformed my thought process, helped me be the father that I am today, showed me what a father should be like by him being the good father that he is to me. As my provider, as my protector, these are things that I wanted to be for my kids. Today I can say that it has made me the man that I am today. I have three daughters of my own that I'm very, very proud of. My oldest being 25 and married. By the grace of God and the help of my wife, I'm a pretty good father. I'm grateful because of the lessons that, you know, God has taught me, and I took, you know, my situation of being fatherless growing up as an opportunity to start something new for my family. God has put me in a very unique position as a pastor. Also causes me to be the spiritual father to a lot of people within the ministry that I am the pastor over. And I constantly pray for them every day. I try to provide for them the best way I know how, protect them the best way I know how. I long to be there for them in every endeavor that they attempt. That's my goal. I want to show them also the Father's heart, God the Father's heart, through my heart. And that's something I take seriously, and I'm honored to be able to do. And so I have a passion, I have a drive, hurt for a lot of kids that are growing up right now without their father, which really caused me to get involved with a group called Our Father's Project. It helps inner city teens, mainly males, but also have some females, who are actually growing up without fathers. And also I have the privilege of mentoring a lot of young men today, helping them with life's struggles, fill that void of not having their father in their lives, actively involved in the church as a pastor, helping young men budget. I mean, these are the things that I wanted, you know, my father to teach me. And every young man desires from their father. I try to give that to the young men that I come in contact with, whether I know them or not. It's my desire to help fill a void that I know that exists. And I know a lot of them act out, because they're missing that attention and that love from a father. And I wanted to be there for them in any way that I possibly can.